Shiva, Faculty of Physics. I hope you are doing well in your studies with these bricks. In this episode, we are going to continue the previous episode, that is heat generation in the capacitive circuits as of part 3. Okay? In the last session, we studied the circuits that contain charging capacitors and discharging batteries. Now, in this episode, we will calculate the expression for the heat energy generated in the capacitor circuit by using this circuit. Okay, so this is circuit 5. In this circuit 5, what we are seeing now? This is one capacitor. This capacitor now charged to the potential 2V and its capacitance is C. So before closing the switch, this is switch. Before closing the switch, what is the charge on this plate? Charge on this plate now plus 2CV. Okay? So at that time, what is the charge on this plate? Charge on this plate is minus 2CV. Okay? So what is the total energy stored between the plates of capacitor before closing the switch? That is E. EI is equal to half C into 2V whole square. That is equal to half C into 4V square. So it will become 2CV square. 2CV square indicates total energy stored between the plates of capacitor before closing the switch. Okay, now you are closing the switch. After closing the switch, what will happen? The potential difference across the plates of capacitor is equal to the potential of the battery. That's why here what we write again, what is the final energy EF? So EF is equal to half into C V square. Okay, so after closing the switch, what is the charge on this plate? So now here potential difference instead of 2V, we have V now. So it will become plus CV, as well as here we have minus V, minus CV. Clearly you can observe, previously here the charge is 2CV. Now you are seeing the charge is CV. Nothing but CV amount of charge now lost by this plate, and the CV amount of charge passing through the battery from positive to negative terminal. Nothing but this part again I am drawing here clearly. Okay, this is battery. Okay, the CV amount of charge now living here passes from positive terminal to negative terminal. So positive terminal lying at potential V, negative terminal at 0. Okay, now here observe carefully. In order to calculate the work done by the battery, so what we can do? So here work done by the battery is equal to delta V into Q. So what is delta V? Delta V now, initial potential V, final potential 0. So final minus initial, it will become V. So Q is CV, it will become minus CV square. Nothing but what is the meaning here? Amount of charge the battery not giving for QC, that is CV. Instead of giving energy to the charge CV, the battery was taking the charge from CV. Nothing but what we can conclude here, battery was not supplying energy to the charge CV. Instead of supplying the energy to the charge CV, battery was absorbing the energy from the charge CV. Nothing but what we can say, this capacitor is in what state? This is discharging state. Capacitor is in discharging state. Battery is in what state? Battery is in charging state. Okay? Now, in this case, what is the total amount of heat energy generated in the circuit? It can be calculated. W is equal to H is equal to W plus EI minus PF. So, what is the value for W here? W is equal to minus CV square plus what is EI? EI is equal to 2CV square minus what is EF? EF is equal to 0.5 CV square. Nothing but 2CV square minus 1.5 CV square. So it will become simply 0.5 CV square. Nothing but amount of heat energy generated during this state when the capacitor start to discharge as well as the battery start to charge. At that time, the amount of heat energy generated in the circuit is 0.5 CV square. Okay. Now, come back to the one more example. This is we are saying as circuit 6. In this circuit 6, you are seeing two capacitors, there is no battery. Okay. One capacitor initially charged to the potential 10 volt, another capacitor charged to the potential 5 volt. Now, this positive plate of the capacitor is connected to this positive plate. Similarly, this negative plate of the capacitor similarly connect to this negative plate after closing the switch. Okay, before closing the switch, what is the charge of this positive plate? So this is now we can say plus 20 microcoulomb, that is CV formula. Q is equal to C into V. Here it will become minus 20 microcoulomb, as well as here this is C into V, 3 into 5, this is plus 50 microcoulomb. Now here again it will become minus 50 microcoulomb. In order to calculate the amount of heat energy generated in this type of circuits, we will use loop rule. Okay, so what is the name of that rule? We can use loop rule. Loop rule says for us, if you are traversing any loop in the circuit, the sum of all potential differences across the entire loop is always equal to 0. This is based upon law of conservation of energy. But remember one point, whenever you are applying the loop rule, you are traversing the capacitor from negative plate to positive plate, take that potential difference always positive. Whenever you are traversing the circuit from positive plate to negative plate, take always that potential with minus sign. So remember the rule we are using here, what type of rule? Loop rule. Okay, so loop rule says what for us? R V's sum is 0. Okay, as well as one more point here, what we need to remember, while traversing the loop, whenever you are moving from negative terminal of the capacitor to the positive terminal of the capacitor, take that voltage with what sign? Positive sign. As well as whenever you are traversing from positive terminal to negative terminal, take that potential with what sign? Plus sign. Suppose I am showing here one little sign dimension. Okay, this is capacitor, say this is A, this is B, this is plus, this is minus. Whenever you are moving from B to A, what is the value of V? That value of V now we can say positive. Whenever you are going from A to B, what is the sign for that V? V sign now we can take for negative. So B to A we can take as positive, A to B we can take as negative. In this manner, whatever may be the loop, how many capacitors that you are seeing in that loop, so just add all these that are equal to 0. While adding the values, follow this rule. If you are going through the capacitor from negative plate to positive plate, its potential is positive. Positive plate to negative plate, its potential negative. And sum of all of that potential differences around that closed loop is equal to 0. Okay. Now let us start to solve this circuit. Okay. So this one lying at higher potential, this one lying at lower potential. Assume this plate now losing some amount of charge, say Q. Okay, this plate now losing some amount of charge, say that is Q. After losing this charge Q, this plate now having the charge 20 minus Q. This Q charge again added to this plate. Now here it will become 15 plus Q. Simultaneously, this plate loses the charge now Q. It will become minus 15 minus Q. This Q charge again added to this one, that is minus 20 plus Q after closing the switch. Okay. So after closing the switch, this 10V and 5V arrived at one single potential. Let us try to calculate what is that single potential value. In order to calculate that single potential value, now travel the circuit. Suppose I am taking this is point E. Now I am traversing the circuit from point A to again point A. In which direction I am showing here? Counterclockwise direction. Okay. Now at that time, what is the equation? Now we can write. Now I am moving in this manner. I am going from negative plate to positive plate. So at that time, voltage across the plates of capacitor is positive. Now what we can write here? So here now we can write this charge on the positive plate 20 minus Q divided by capacitance, that is 2. So you are going from minus to plus, that's why this term positive. Again you are going from plus to minus, plus to minus. At that time we will get negative sign for that voltage of this capacitor. Now we can write minus of 15 plus Q divided by 3 is equal to 0. But remember, it is not mandatory to go from A to A in the anticlockwise direction. You can go from A to A in the clockwise direction also. Suppose I am going in the clockwise direction, what we can write? I am moving in this manner, reaches from negative plate to positive plate. Now what we can write again? Charge on this plate 15 plus Q divided by capacitance 3. I am going from negative to positive, that's why the potential we can put what sign here? Plus sign only. Again I am moving in this manner, reaches this plate, but I am going from positive to negative, that's why the voltage is negative. Charge on the positive plate, this is 20 minus Q divided by its capacitance 2. Okay, now observe carefully. This equation I got by traversing the loop in which direction? That is anticlockwise. This equation I got by traversing the loop in which direction? So in this manner, clockwise. So even you are traversing the circuit in the clockwise direction as well as in the anticlockwise direction, in both cases we are getting same result. That's why you are allowed to use freely in any equation. Whatever may be the equation that we are using, always keeps the point to remember. Sum of all delta V's are equal to 0. And you are moving from negative to positive plate of the capacitor, there be positive. positive to negative plate of the capacitor, there V is positive, all of that sum is equal to 0. Now you can use either equation. Suppose I am using this equation, what we can write now? 20 minus Q by 2 is equal to 15 plus Q by 3. Now do cross multiplication, what we can get? 60 minus 3Q is equal to 30 plus 2Q. So 30 is equal to 5Q. Then Q will become 6 microcoulomb. Nothing but after closing the switch, the amount of charge transferred from this plate, that is 6 microcoulomb. Nothing but. So after closing the switch, what are the charges on these plates? Now we will try to mention these charges roughly again here. So 20 minus 6, this is 6 now. 20 minus 6 here it will become 14. So this is 14 microcoulomb. This one minus 14 microcoulomb. This one already 15 plus Q, 15 plus 6, 21 microcoulomb. Again this one minus 21 microcoulomb. This is 2 microfarad, but after connecting this one with switch, its potential also V. Now this is 3 microfarad. This potential also what number is? V only. Okay. Now what is this V value? Now V we know Q by C. That's why this value for V now either 14 by 2, otherwise 21 by 3, it will become simply 7 volt, nothing but after closing the switch, both of the capacitor plates arrive at what potential? 7 volts. Remember, instead of using this Kirchhoff's loop rule, we are able to solve this problem by using the principle of law of conservation of charge. So law of conservation of charge states what for us? The total charge of an isolated system is always constant. Total charge of the isolated system is always constant, nothing but total charge that we have before the time t, total charge that we have after time t, nothing but in our case, total charge on the plates of capacitor before closing the switch is equal to total charge on the capacitor plates after closing the switch. Now, one time C is diagram again carefully. So I am showing now here one dotted line. Okay. So this part now I am showing here. One dotted line. This dotted line encloses these two plates. Okay. So this is I am showing some dotted line. This dotted line encloses two plates, this plate as well as this plate. On these two plates, what is the total charge that we have initially before closing the switch? Total charge initially before closing the switch that we have, this is 20 microcoulomb. This is that we have 15 microcoulomb. This is 20 microcoulomb. This is 15 microcoulomb. When? Before closing the switch. Okay, after closing the switch there what will happen? There is no chance for this 20 microcoulomb or 50 microcoulomb to escape out of these plates. Just this 20 microcoulomb and 15 microcoulomb redistribute itself along this wire only on these two plates. That's why the total charge that we have on this positive plate or on this positive plate before closing the switch and after the closing switch just redistribute itself, but this total charge, that is 20 plus 15, that is 35 microcoulomb, is always constant. Okay, now what we can write again here? From principle of conservation of charge. So total charge before closing the switch, what is that value? 20 plus 15, that is 20 plus 15. After closing the switch, this one reaches same potential V. This one also reaches same potential V. That's why Q is equal to again CV. So 2V again plus 3V. So it will become 3V is equal to 5V. Sorry, 35 is equal to 5V. V again will get the 7 volt. So this is based upon Kirchhoff's loop rule. This is based upon principle of the conservation of the charge. Okay, now we evaluated the common potential after closing the switch. Now, what is the total energy stored between the plates before closing the switch? Total energy stored in the plates before closing the switch. So what is that value? Half into, so 2 into capacitance 2. What is the potential there? V 10 volt, that is 10 square 100 plus 40 split, half into 3 into 25. Okay, so this is the total energy stored between the plates of capacitor just before closing the switch. Just after the closing the switch, there what we can write? EF is equal to, now half, so that one C value 2. So what is the V value? V there 7 volt, that's why we can write 49 plus half into 3 into 49. So now what we can write here, heat energy developed H is equal to W plus EI minus EF. Since there is no battery, okay, so in this circuit are you seeing any battery? So in this circuit there is no battery. If there is no battery, means work done by the external source is equal to 0. So W is equal to 0 here due to the no battery. Now simply substitute the value of E and EF, what we can write? H is equal to, so here take half common. So now we can write half into 2 into 100, 200 plus 3 into 25, 75 minus. So here this one 5 into 49. So it will become 59, 45, totally it is 24, 245. Now again it will become half into 75 minus 45. So it will become half into 30, it will become 50 micro joule, sorry, not micro joule, already we have taken their micro, na? So simply it will become 15 micro joule, okay, not simply joules. Okay, students, in this session we studied about how the heat energy we can calculate in the case of circuit where we have the capacitor in the state of discharging, battery in the state of charging. Later, we have tried to calculate the heat energy generated in the circuit in the absence of battery, where we have just two capacitors. There we have calculated the potential V, that is 7 volt, either by using loop rule, otherwise by using law of conservation of charge. With the help of either loop rule or law of conservation of charge, we calculated 7 volt. Later, we calculated the amount of heat energy developed in that circuit by calculating or by using this formula. In this formula, WV to 0. Finally, we got the total heat energy generated in the circuit is 15 microjoule. I hope you understood this lecture well. In the next episode, we will meet with one or two important circuits in order to emphasize this heat generation only more. Thank you for watching.